The world was stunned last weekend when Mexico's top drug kingpin, Joaquin El Chapo Guzman, engineered a stunning prison break. It was the second time that the world's richest drug trafficker had managed somehow to escape the clutches of Mexican authorities. He had supposedly slipped out of a prison by hiding in a laundry cart the first time. 14 years later, U.S. and Mexican authorities re-arrested Guzman, who heads the Sinaloa cartel. The February 2014 operation was a complicated one, months in the making. And when El Chapo was arrested last year, the U.S. requested extradition, worried about another escape. But Mexico refused. According to AP, Guzman escaped last weekend via, quote, a sophisticated mile-long tunnel with ventilation, lighting, and a motorcycle apparently used to move dirt. The Mexican government just released CCTV footage of Guzman's last moments in his prison cell before he disappeared into the shower, never to come back. The escape is being seen as a major embarrassment for Mexico and could strain ties with the U.S. Joining me now live from Mexico City is Joan Grillo. He is the author of El Narco, Inside Mexico's Criminal Insurgency. Welcome to Uprising.
Good to be here, Sonali.
Thanks for joining us. Well, Guzman is a billionaire. He's made Forbes' list. First, before we get into what's just happened, to set context for our U.S. audience who may not be as familiar with him, can you explain how he made his money and how much blood is on his hands?
Well, Chapo Guzman has been a drug trafficker all his life, basically. He grew up in a rough village in a state called Sinaloa in the Sierra Madre Mountains, where people have been growing opium and trafficking that opium to the United States for 100 years. When Washington, D.C. first made opium and cocaine illegal in the Harrison's Narcotics Tax Act in 1914, people in Sinaloa began to grow it and traffic it to the United States. So he grew up in this environment, and as he was growing up, the drug trade grew massively in size. There was first the marijuana boom in the United States in the 1960s, with many young Americans smoking marijuana and buying it from Mexico. Then there was the cocaine boom in the 1970s, with everyone taking cocaine in discos and then people taking crack, you know, on the streets. And then later on, he also got into trafficking crystal meth. So he makes this enormous amount of money trafficking drugs. He's head of one of the most sophisticated cartels of many Mexican cartels, who can move these drugs and can move the money through banks, through businesses, and around the world.